So Steve, two changes to the starting 15 on the weekend?
Yeah, to the starting 15. So we're going to put Tom Banks at fullback and Aidan Tour on the left wing. Aidan's got tremendous experience. He's a very good communicator on the field, and he'll give us good direction from that left wing. And I think Banksy has performed well when he's played fullback, so we want to give him another chance there. And then Chris Alcock comes back into the starting team after a week off or a couple of weeks off, and he's nice and fresh now, feeling very refreshed and certainly over the little niggly injury that he had.
And on the bench, there's a first possible first cap for Andy Muirhead.
Yeah, that's right. So we've included Andy Muirhead in the 23, and hopefully he'll get his opportunity. I mean, he's come down to Canberra pre-Christmas last year just for an opportunity. Wasn't part of the contracted squad, but came down to train with us and has played his club footy with Royals this year in Canberra, and has done a fantastic job there. And on the back of that, we've been saying it, well, probably for the last 6 weeks, is that we expect the boys to go back to club and play exceptional footy, and he's been doing that, so he's been rewarded with an opportunity this weekend.
Kings pose a difficult challenge and certainly a different proposition than they looked like they might be about even 4 weeks ago.
Yeah, I mean, they've had three good wins in a row now, which is a record for the Kings. They beat the Sharks for the first time ever last week. They had 30,000 at the ground here in Port Elizabeth. So they're on a bit of a roll. They've got a very dangerous back three. I know they've got an injury to their fullback at the moment, but their back three are very fast, electric, and probably the quickest in the competition. They've got Lionel Cronje playing 10, who played with us for a number of years. And he's playing some really good football at the moment. So he's marching them around the paddock really well, making a couple of line breaks, kicking the ball well, and showing a lot of skill on the field. And then they've got a forward pack, a typical South African forward pack, big, aggressive, no nonsense.
And have the boys settled in after the long travelling over the past week?
Yeah, so we had an unusual trip this year. We went, we came over here on the Sunday. We stayed the night in Johannesburg, then we flew down here on the Tuesday morning. Yeah, it was unusual, but I think it's worked well for us. It enabled us to get a good training session in Canberra on the Sunday before we flew out. We've had two sessions now in Port Elizabeth. The first one was at the university over here, and it was a little bit of knowledge, a little bit of drilling, a little bit of knowledge on the back of 2 days of long travel. We didn't want to work the boys too hard, and then today was a really good hit out, so we did a good full session, 60 minutes out here on the field, and went through everything that we need to go through, knowing that tomorrow's captain's run will be in an enclosed stadium, and we don't want to give too much away.
Finally, how important is this next box of fixtures before the international break for the club?
Yeah, well, I think you know, our last couple of games have been a bit disappointing. We've had six losses this year by less than 7 points. So the season could certainly be a different story if we had a little bit more composure at the end of the game, and it's sort of the same story over the last couple of weeks. So for us, leading into the June window, we've got this game this weekend, we've got the Jaguares next weekend, and then we're back home to play the Rebels. So three very important games for the boys, and in the context of the season, probably our most important.